Today I'm going to show you how we can create a cake in Blender. So let's start baking. So I start this cake project with this cylinder, because cakes usually are cylinder, and then I scale, and then with ASCII and then C plus Z I scale it like this. So we have very cool shape here, and then I add here a few loop cuts by pressing Ctrl plus R and then mouse wheel. I add here that kind of loops, and then I select this one by pressing Alt plus Shift plus right mouse button and then Ctrl plus B, and now with mouse I can control this bevel, and mouse wheel I add little bit more segments here. Something like this looks very good. And let's select these two, this one and this one, Alt plus Shift plus right mouse button, and then I bevel those also a little bit. So Ctrl plus B, and then I add one segment here in the center like that, and then I select these two, and the Alt plus Shift plus right mouse button is still the shortcut, and then I press S and then Shift plus Z, so I prevent it from scaling in Z axis. Okay, that looks very good. Now I add here subdivision surface modifier. And looks good, but now we have this problem here. So how we fix that is that we select this one here and we add bevel here also. Ctrl plus B. Something like this I think is very good. And here from this transform whatever menu this is, I select this smooth. Okay, and let's go here in this materials tab, and let's click this new, and let's call this first material cake one, and let's drag here new editor from this widget, and then let's select here node editor, where is it, this one. Alright, so we have here this diffuse PSDF, and we don't need that. So with control button down I can draw this kind of thing, which is going to cut that line between of these two nodes, and with X key I delete that. And instead of using the diffuse, we are going to use the principled. So let's press Shift plus A and then search and then principled PSDF, and let's connect this to the surface like that. Now if we here in this, by the way you should have here cycles render to do these steps, I hope you understand already. Okay, so now if we in this view we press Shift plus Z, we see the material how it looks like, and it looks very, I don't know what is it, but it's not what we want something more detailed. And I make this roundness little bit more round, and then I select here some base color for this, and I select some cake kind of color, but this is just a placeholder color because we are going to add later an image texture there, but I think it's cool if we have some color there. So I select this kind of color, and then I click, actually I think we don't need that scene tint, and maybe a little bit of this subsurface scattering also, and it's going to take this color to the subsurface scattering, and it's going to kind of let the light go through of this object, and it creates a little bit of that color. If I put here like full, then you can see the effect. So we want to have only a little bit of that. Something like that I think might be very okay. So that's I think very good material now, and let's click this. Actually, let's click this new, this plus icon, and let's select from this button the cake one, and let's click this plus icon here. So we created a copy of this material, and let's call this cake 2. And now here in this view, let's press Shift plus Z again, and we see we have here this cake one. Let's select it and let's scroll down to the settings here, and then let's select here some color for that. Actually, we can drag and drop this color to the viewport color. Okay, looking pretty good, I think. And now I go here in face selection mode, and with Alt plus Shift plus right mouse button and then Control plus, I select this center part of this cake, and then I select this cake too, and I click this assign button. And what I'm gonna do, I will select here some other color, and I wanna have a little bit lighter color here, something like that. And then I drag and drop this also to the base color of the principled shader. So that I think looks very cool cake, and let's maybe move it a little bit up. Actually, I will move it quite up like this maybe. And how I kind of snap it like that is that I have control button down when I move it like that. So I think this is very good place for the cake. Now the next thing we need to do is to create the chocolate or whatever cream or whatever is poured over that cake, you know, something like that. And I'm gonna use the liquid simulation here in Blender. So the chocolate here over this cake. And first I need to create the fluid domain, because this is going to be fluid simulation, of course. And the fluid domain is going to be cube. And let's go in top view. And let's press 5 to have orthographic view. Okay, like this. And then let's move it here in the center and go in edit mode. And we wanna scale this quite big, so it's at least bigger than the cake. Something like this I think works very well. Alright, and let's go in edit mode back, and let's move this bottom part here so it's touching the surface of the cake, and then let's move this down so we don't create too much of domain, because how big is this, the bigger, slower is the baking of the fluid simulation, so you wanna have as small as possible fluid domain, but not too small, because if it's too small, then you will have weird edges in your fluid simulation, and that also is something you don't wanna have. So okay, let's call this finished now, and then let's create the fluid object, and I will add here cylinder, and I go in edit mode, and I scale it in Z axis, and I move it here. Maybe it can be a little bit bigger. I go in edge selection mode and I scale this bottom part like this. Then I will move it here. Maybe even more. Okay, this I think works quite nicely. I hope so. And let's select the fluid domain and let's go here in physics settings. And let's click here this fluid. And we have now this drop menu, which calls now none, but we select here domain. Okay, cool. And then let's select this one here and let's click this fluid again, and then let's select here fluid. And let's select the cake and activate this fluid and then type and obstacle. Alright, let's stop this baking because it's kind of taking too much processing power, and we don't need that. And now if I bake this again, the fluid starts to do what it's expected to do. And now I need to figure out the settings for this fluid, because this don't look like a chocolate, or it doesn't actually look anything very good. Okay, and yeah, let's start doing the settings. So all the settings are going to be for this domain object. So let's select the domain object. The fluid is kind of the domain. We can hide even this. No. So let's select the domain, and then here let's start first with the resolution. This is how good quality it is, maybe wrong way to say it, but this is kind of the quality of the fluid. So I will put 100, and then for the preview I will put 1, because I'm not going to use the preview of this fluid. And then I will go for his viewport display settings, and I select here final. So now we see how the animation looks like when it's rendered, and it's a little bit better. And then I select here smooth sailing, because I don't want to see those corners and things there. Okay, and the next setting I'm gonna do is this real world size, and I put here 0.28, and because it was meters, and now it's kind of almost half of the half meter. It was half meter before, so no, this is not exactly the size of the cake, but it's, I think, close enough. Okay, and then I will put here for the base number 2, and then for the exponent I will put here 5, and then I actually have here the viscosity preset honey already, so but I have edited it a little bit, so 5 here and 2 here. Okay, and now we can start baking this animation. So let's go frame 0 and click this bake button, this, and it might be that we need to change the size of the fluid object. There is not very good way to know in which size or how big the fluid should be in the object. So I'm sorry, this is just what we need to do. And this is already looking quite cool, I think. Yeah, and we have this problem here, but don't worry about that, because we are going to fix it. We are going to fix everything. I think something like this looks very cool. And I think I can now stop baking by clicking this button, and then I can go here in the modifiers and I click apply. And now we have lots of stuff we don't need in this animation. So let's go here in the edit mode, and let's select this by pressing L and then X, delete vertices, and we need to delete lots of stuff now. Oh, not that, because we created lots of. So with Alt key, just keep selecting all the not needed things in the simulation. Maybe that not also either. I think that's now very good. Maybe this also not going to be there. Okay. And now we need to sculpt this, because it looks a little bit, if I can say it, ugly. So we go here in from this menu, we select here sculpt mode, and with F key you can make the brush a little bit bigger. And we have here all the settings, so I will select here smooth, and then let's reduce the strength a little bit, and now I just start clicking here. Oh, wait a minute, we have here this symmetry lock tab, so just click this mirror X, so we don't have the symmetry anymore. I don't know why it's automatically selected in Blender, but that just is one you need to do. So let's smooth this fluid a little bit. And if you wanna do some special edits there, you can do that also with different brushes. For example, if we select here this inflate deflate thing, then you can kind of make this kind of blobs there. Is that even a word? I will make blobs. But yeah, you can make more smooth looking shapes with that. And I think this works perfectly with this specific project we are doing. And if you wanna deflate the, create negative values with this brush, you can press Ctrl down and it will create kind of holes there. Like that. Okay. Let's say we are very happy about this now. So let's go out from the sculpt node in object mode and let's keep editing this. I wanna remove this part here because I don't like it. I just wanna have this here but not that one. So I select here one edge and then Ctrl plus. I select this area and delete by pressing X and delete faces. And then I select this area and press F. And it creates there a face. And then I press Ctrl plus F. And then triangulate faces. So now the topology is kind of similar with the other areas. Alright, and now we need to delete that also. That looks very stupid here and we have this kind of weird shape. So I just go in side numbered 1 view. And then with Z I go in wireframe mode and then with B, which means box select, I select this whole area and Ctrl plus I select the whole thing and then I just press, actually we can try, let's select here some of the edges to be active. When the edge is active, it is this kind of little bit lighter. And I selected with it with Ctrl click. So let's here use active element. So now this is the median point of this operation. So now if we press S and Z, we can make it smaller. Or even remove the whole thing. Okay, that's better. We don't need to delete anything. And I will edit a little bit it with the sculpt thing. So here the smooth brush and then let's make the thing disappear. I will add more strength to this operation so it's faster. Something like that. Alright, let's go back to object mode and then let's add here subdivision surface modifier. And that adds a little bit more details to this. It kind of sharpens the areas. So I think it's very good. No, cool. And now if you wanna fix some topology problems, you need to go in edit mode. And if for example, let's find something we wanna fix. This one, if we wanna fix that. We go in edit mode and then we see what's happening here. And most of the time there is just this kind of pinching thing. So we wanna fix it by selecting this area and then Alt plus M merge at center. And now it's gone. And that kind of little project you will have lots of there. I already can see that we have here one. So let's select that also and merge at center. But I think I'm not going to fix everything here. It may be okay that it's not perfect. You can use your whole day by fixing this if you want to do so. But I think I'm now very happy about this and I'm gonna leave it like that. Okay, this has to be fixed. So the tutorial will not become too stupid or long. I will not use time for that anymore. And let's here select the materials and click new material. And then we have here this surface. And let's select here principled PSDF. Like this. And then for the base color, let's select some chocolate kind of material. And here the settings, viewport color, let's drag and drop this here also. So we can see. And No, if we press C plus chat, we already can see how it looks like. And I kind of love how it looks like, but it looks kind of too bad, if I can use that word here. So how do I remove that wetness in this simulation? This is not simulation anymore. This object, I will add more roundness to this. And I think something like this, it might be a little bit better. And then I also wanna have here subsurface scattering, and this is the setting for that. And if we add here like too much, just like in the cake, we can see what kind of different effect we can create with that. But I just wanna have only a little bit of this. And we can also control the effect with this subsurface color. So if we add here some, maybe a little bit more like an orange color, it will not look so scary. Okay, this is the setting I think I'm going with this material. And I wanna add also some bump mapping here, and I just create very fastly here noise texture, and I attach it to the displacement like that, and then I will add the details. Let's see, let's make the scale a little bit smaller. I mean, bigger number means smaller details, and let's add a little bit distortion also here, and actually okay, I can't see anything. Let's remove a little bit the details. And let's add more distortion. Okay, that I think already looks a little bit better. So I wanted to have this kind of random details there. And maybe even more distortion. Is it a bad idea? Maybe not. But if you wanna have more distortion and still see the details, you can set the scale bigger and then add back distortion like that. But I don't know, maybe it should not distort too much. This looks, I think, very good. Like that. And then I will add mat node here to control the amount of this texture here. So let's just shift a search mat and let's add it here, and then let's select here multiply. And now with this, well, if we put here 0, there is not anymore anything with those, but we of course wanna see a little bit of those. So something like 0.5 or 4. Or even more. Now it's again up to you what you wanna achieve with this. Okay, I think I wanna have one more level in this cake. So how I do that, I need to dissolve here something. This is just some practice. Let's select this one by pressing Alt plus Shift plus right mouse press button and then X and dissolve edges. And let's do the same here also. Okay, and now we can extrude one more level to this building. And then let's go in edge selection mode and let's bevel this one, just like we did those other levels. And then S, Shift plus Z. Okay, that's pretty good. And then the bevel here. So Control plus B. Let's make it. Let's do it. And now I just need to select here Control plus again, and then Control minus. And let's select this material here and assign. Alright. I think it's very good like that. actually think that this might be a little bit too deep. So I scale it a little bit back. Okay, why it's located like that? Let's hide this for a while. And then let's go to top view. And let's start editing. Let's select this one, top view, and set. Okay, it's so much in wrong place. I need to move it back. And let's scale it a little bit back also. Okay, let's unhide the chocolate by pressing Alt plus H. And then we have here this thing we can just delete also. Now when we have the cake, we are going to add some cream. Some cream balls or whatever those are here. So let's create here one mesh and circle. And I'm gonna have here 16 of vertices, which I think is very good amount. And then let's press tab to go in edit mode. And then let's select the vertex selection mode. And then let's go here in select and checker deselect. And you should have here second selection like that. And we are just going to scale it like that. So we have this kind of star shape here. And I think this is very good now. And then I'm gonna scale it to very small. And then I press E to extrude and I scale it. That and then I press E to and move it in Z axis like this, and then E to extrude and scale and move like this, and then let's one more time do this, and then let's press E again and then left click and Alt plus M merge at center, and we have here this one center vertex like that. That's very cool. And let's select everything and control plus N because those normals seems to be wrong. And then let's go to modifiers and let's add here subdivision surface modifier. So with that we create that kind of onion kind of shape here, which I think is very cool for this. And let's see what happens if we have two subdivisions. Actually very good. And let's apply this. So we have lots of geometry now here, and let's go here and select this top vertex, and let's here select the proportional editing enable, and let's go to top view, and then let's press R to rotate, and let's rotate it like that. Alright, that's very cool shape, and then maybe we wanna have one more subdivision surface to smooth that. That's very beautiful, and I think, yeah, we don't need two levels of that, so one level is enough. Let's again select this top one here, and now we can move this little bit like this, and rotate maybe a little bit, so it's not so, it's not too perfect, the shape. Something like this I think is very good, and let's select that, and let's start duplicating it, and let's also rotate it every time a little bit. So Shift plus D, and then rotate a little bit like that, and something like that. How many we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm gonna actually select all of them, and then let's select here individual origins, and then I scale them a little bit smaller. So I don't know why, but I wanna have 8 of these here. So it's kind of cool amount of foam things. So yeah. Alright. Shift plus Z to see how it looks like. Okay, I am getting very hungry. Now we need to create a material for those. So let's go here and click this new and let's call this cream. And let's delete this diffuse. So select it and press X. And let's add here principled principled, and let's connect it to the surface. And let's select here some little bit yellowish color. And here I'm gonna press numpad slash so I isolate this new object so I can go in rendered mode and it renders very fast, as you can see. So I will also add here a little bit of subsurface scattering because it's green, so it should have something like that. So let's see what we can do. Maybe we have a little bit too much yellowness, huh? And also reduce the roughness from the reflections. Actually, maybe it's easier to add that before we have the subsurface scattering, so we kind of see the quality of the material with that. So it's now a little bit too sharp, so let's go back with the roughness. I think that looks very okay. Still a little bit too little. Okay, that might be something that the cream has. And then let's go back with the subsurface scattering. Maybe I go here back to a little bit more white. No, I have no scientific knowledge of how the cream should look like and what values I should use there, but I just do what looks tasty for me. Alright. Maybe I reduce a little bit of this specular. Actually, I think it can work even better without so sharp reflections. So I add even more roughness to it. Just playing with the settings. You might end up having something completely different. But I think I'm happy about this now for a while at least. And then we can go here in the material settings. And let's add here some color so we can see that we have material here. And let's press numpad slash again. And we need to assign the same material for all of those cream things. So let's select all of them with shift and right click. And last one, this will be that one with which have the material. And let's select it also. And then control plus L and make links. And then select this materials. So now we have the same material to all of those things. And looking pretty good. Like that, and let's maybe rotate this light. I will use nodes here, and I will create a little bit bigger size for the sun lamp. And let's add here something like 5 maybe. Let's see how it works now. Works pretty good, maybe 5, but was a little bit overkill, so let's put 4 maybe. And then I go here in the, what is this, scene settings, and then let's select this color management, and here color space, why do I always misspell everything, and filmic lock, and then Weave, and then let's select filmic and then look, and let's use maybe high contrast. So now we have a little bit more realistic lighting. Maybe the high contrast was a little bit too much. Let's try for a while at least with this medium high contrast. All right, and now we need to create more cream. So let's select this ring here, and then let's press Shift plus S and snap cursor to select it. So we have the cursor perfectly in the center of this circle. And then let's go out from the edit mode by pressing Tab, and let's unselect everything. And now we are going to add here one circle. And we also want to have more segments here, so let's start with 32, for example, and let's scale it so it's a little bit bigger than the cake. This is going to be the cream, and this is going to be a texture trick. And I'm gonna move it a little bit down, and then I extrude by pressing E, and then I press Z, so I move it in the Z axis, and Control plus N, and seems like it's not in the center. I will move it a little bit. I really wanna have it in the center. I don't know. S, Shift plus Z. Okay. No, I think it's quite good. We will fix it later if there's some problems. And then let's select it and let's have smooth shading. And we need to start creating material for that. So let's click new and then let's call this cream. I don't know, rings. I don't know, that was just some random idea. And we have here again this diffuse, so let's delete it and let's add principled PSDF and let's connect it to the surface. And we actually should have here the same setting as we have here for those. So actually, let's delete that principle and let's select that one and then let's select this principle and let's copy it by pressing Ctrl plus C and let's go back to this material and Ctrl plus V. So we have the exact similar material here also. Alright. And then we gonna have here mix shader. And let's connect this here, and then we have gonna have transparent shader, and let's connect this to the bottom part, bottom slot of this mix shader thing here, which I think is very important. And then the next thing is to have here gradient texture. So let's find gradient texture, and let's connect this to the factory. Like that. And now we can isolate this object by pressing number slash, so we can look how it works, how it kind of looks. And let's add here, by the way, now we need node wrangle addon. So go to the user preferences and let's find here node wrangle, like that, and then let's select this one and Control plus T with the node wrangle, it works perfectly. And let's select here this object, which is very important also, and then let's add here color ramp, like that, and then we need to rotate this texture. So let's here for the Y coordinate, let's put here 19. And now we don't see it anymore, the texture is kind of gone. But we need to move it a little bit. So here we have the location things. So put here something like, I don't know, 0.5 maybe. And then let's move here. So we are trying to have here the center, the thing that we have the center part visible and it's kind of fading to the other direction. So let's add here one more and it has to be white also. And now let's find the texture wherever it is by moving this. And this is little weird job to do, but I don't know at least any better way to do that. The problem actually is that I don't know where is the other part of that. Okay, now it's working. But let's here have ease. Okay, now I think it's kind of working. Yeah. And then we wanna mix that. So let's add here mix RGB and let's connect this to that one. And we wanna have this in the bottom slot. And then now it's looking very weird. By the way, now I can see that it's not in the center. So we need to move it a little bit. Alright, now it's good. So we wanna have here a noise texture. So let's find noise texture and let's connect this to the second slot like that. And then let's maybe duplicate this ramp here. And let's delete the other part of this by pressing this minus button. And then something like this, I don't know. And then let's press here also. Actually, we can use this same. So let's connect this object to the noise texture. And now we need to find some settings for this noise. So I will try it, I don't know, something like this. And then let's add more details to it. And maybe a little bit also distortion. That's, I think, very good. And let's put here 100%. Actually, it's not working like that. Oh, we should have here multiply. Okay, now it's working. And then let's duplicate this again. And now with this we can control how the kind of thing works. I think the texture is a little bit too big, so I change the scale even smaller. And with this I'm gonna control a little bit how it's working. Alright, so my recording program just crashed and that made me to lost some of my files. But here's what I have now. So let's check this material. So we have the texture coordinates, then we have the mapping and gradient texture and the color ramp and the multiply node and the noise texture, which is going to be mixed with that multiply node with the gradient texture. And then I have another color ramp here, and then I have mix shader and transparent mixed with principled. And then I have this, I'm using this noise texture also here as a displacement, and then I have this multiply node. So let's see how it looks like here. It looks like that. And because it looks like that, I will add here also the shrink wrap modifier, and then I click this pipette tool and I select the cake. And then I add a little bit offset for it. Like that. And let's see again. That just works very good. And now I can just duplicate this object by pressing Shift plus D and I move it here to this part. And let's do it again here. And the cake should be just fine. And let's see. And now we have the exact similar pattern in the all of those green things there. So I just rotate this a little bit in Z axis like that. So rotate that and then rotate that also. So now that the pattern is kind of different in all of them. At least we can notice the pattern. And then I wanna create some candles there. So let's put the 3D cursor here and let's add here cylinder, and I think something like let's see, maybe 6 is very good. So we have 3 stripes there rotating the candle. Actually, let's add a little bit more. so it's a little bit more circular. And then smooth setting, and then let's go to edit mode and S to scale and C plus Z. And we create this kind of candle looking thing. Is it a little bit too long? Maybe it's... I will scale it a little bit like that. And then I'm going to isolate it also. And we wanna have here quite much of these segments because we are going to create a circular kind of, you know, spiral here. So let's here use the proportional editing, and then let's press Z and press R and then Z, and then just rotate it like that. Actually, I wanna select here linear. Alright, that's just beautiful. Let's create a material for this. Let's click here new and let's call this box. And let's here delete the diffuse. And let's add principled. And let's connect it here. And now we can go in rendered mode. We wanna have subsurface scattering here. And the material, I'm not going to create very specific kind of things here. It's kind of cool like that already. And then I just duplicate this by pressing this plus icon here, and I select the wax again, and then I click this plus here. And now I select the base color here and select some red here. And now let's go here in face selection mode and press Alt plus Shift plus right mouse button, and we wanna select every second of those, and then click assign. So now if we render, we have this very cool looking pattern there. And let's also have some viewport colors. Actually, I think the reflection is a little bit too sharp now when we can see it here. So I add the roughness a little bit back. And maybe let's add even more. Something like that. And then I copy this and I go to original box and I paste it here. Like that. Very easy and simple. And let's select this one here and press E to extrude and S to let's disable the proportional editing. And S to scale. And then let's extrude it in Z axis like that. And now we have the pattern here also, but I don't wanna have it here. So I select those, and then I select the box here, and then assign. And we actually need to create another material. Control plus, and let's call this as a string. And assign, and this is also going to be principled. So let's add this to the surface and base color something very dark, and the material is already good like that. Something like that is very beautiful. Let's add little segments here and let's use the proportional editing again to a little bit add randomness to this shape. Like this, and let's add also some color here so we can see that we have actually some material there. And I also wanna have some sort of stand for this, so I just select this part here and disable the proportional editing and C plus D, and then let's scale a little bit and let's extrude a little bit in Z axis, sorry, and let's delete that one faces, and then let's press E and S and Shift plus Z again to create that kind of thing. And now we wanna select only every second of those, so select checker deselect and E to extrude and S to scale and Shift plus Z. Oh wait a minute, here median point, so like this. and it's very cool, but I think we wanna have here rounded edges, so rounded corners for those. So Control plus Shift plus B, and we add bevels to those vertices like that. Cool. And now I'm gonna select these, and I am going to actually move them a little bit up. Okay, it's not working like that. And maybe that's okay. Let's add here also additional edges. So I just select those vertices and then I press G. Like that. That's very neat. Let's select the whole thing and press E to extrude and then C plus Z. Actually, I wanna deselect these parts before I scale them. Like that. This is just one of those jobs. Let's deselect also those. Okay, now I can scale them. Shift plus Z. As Shift plus Z. Okay, and then let's select this again and E to extrude and scale. And then move a little bit down and then extrude again. So this is the stand for this whole candle. Let's select everything and Control plus N. And I wanna also create material for that, because this is not going to be wax, as you can see it looks stupid. So let's select it by pressing L and then let's create here new material again and click this one and let's call this plastic. And let's delete the diffuse and let's add principled and let's connect it to the surface. And now I wanna have some pink color maybe. Let's see how it looks like. Oh, I need to select the stand and then assign. And let's add also here some pink color so we can see the material is assigned. And let's see. That's good. I will maybe add a little bit subsurface scattering also, because it's so thin plastic. And now we just select which colors it's going to scatter. Maybe I'm happy with that. So let's select the whole thing and press numpad slash again. So we have cool candle. And is it a little bit too big? We can scale it maybe like that. And let's move it. And now we can duplicate that. So I will add a candle in between of those foam things. I always rotate them also. Very nice and easy. Let's see how the cake looks now. Looks very tasty. And also we need to create fire. And you maybe think that we are going to create a smoke simulation. But no, I am instead of doing the smoke simulation, I'm going to model the fire. Because I hate smoke simulations. Okay, they are good for some places, but I think for this we can do with the test model. So I add here cube and then I scale it in edit mode like this. And then let's select this here and move maybe down and scale. And then, you know, I'm just creating the fire shape. And let's select everything and press W and subdivide smooth. And let's add more cuts here. And with this smoothness we can control how it's going to be. Okay, that's very weird. Let's select maybe this one and then proportional editing and let's just scale it a little bit. Like that. Let's select everything again and then smooth vertex. Okay, I think I'm happy about this model. You can do other kind of edits there if you want to. Maybe I make it a little bit smaller, like that. So what I do now is to select here shading smooth, and then new material, and let's call this flame, because it's flame. And this material is to going to is going to be not diffuse, but it's going to be emission, and let's connect it to the surface. So now if we render, it's going to emit light, but it's emitting now completely white light, and that's not what I wanna do. Let's add here gradient texture, and let's connect this color to the color of the emission. And then Ctrl plus T, we add here those two nodes, and then connect this object, and then we wanna rotate it a little bit. I need to sneak my other file so I can remember the settings. So yeah, I rotate it 90 degrees here, and then let's add here color ramp to this one, and then for this I wanna have here blue color, something like that, and then next one is going to be yellow, and then we have the white. But I will want also move it a little bit down, because we can't see any more those other colors. I mean, the yellow is so far up. So here I'm gonna move it a little bit down, something like that. And now we can a little bit better how it's looking. Let's here select ease. Okay, maybe that's good. And then we are going to mix it with transparent. So let's add mix shader, and then transparent PSDF, and let's connect this to the other slot of this mix node. And then let's add here layer weight node and this phasing. So now if you look very closely here, this flame, we see that the object is kind of fading to the transparent, and we wanna have more of that effect. So I add here something like 0.9900, and then it's going to be very cool looking effect like that. But I also wanna make it that it's kind of fading in this direction also, and for that I need another gradient texture. So let's duplicate this gradient texture here, and then I'm going to use this one also to this one. So we have now here layer weight and gradient texture, and then I'm gonna mix those together with alt button down and right click. I mix them like that, and then let's connect them to this one. And here I wanna use screen, and then 100%, and then I will add here color ramp to this one, and now with this I can control how it's kind of fading. Let's add here one more, and maybe ease. If we switch those, no effect. I will add here also color ramp to this one. So let's see. Maybe let's reduce a little bit of this. Oh, let's use here the phasing and ease. Okay, let's see how it looks like now. And the mixer. Okay, I need to switch those two. And let's here try multiply. And then we need to move this here, and this is going to be black. Like that. Okay, now I think it's working. Let's add more strength to this emission because it's so dim, and I think it should be brighter. Something like that. I'm very happy about this now. Let's also have here some viewport color. And yeah. Top view, and then I'm gonna duplicate these to all of the candles. Maybe Alt plus D now. And Alt plus D creates a duplicate that is going to be the same object. So it makes basically the rendering faster. Let's see how this looks like now. The candle. I think pretty good. Okay, the next thing I think would be to create some sort of stand for this cake. And I'm gonna create a new cylinder this time. And let's add more segments, more vertices here. Maybe 32, because, you know, that's... Oh, what's that? 32. And then let's scale it in edit mode in z-axis, and let's move up so it's kind of touching the bottom part of this cake. And let's scale and shift plus z like this, and let's see. Okay, maybe a little bit more. And let's select this part here and E to insert, and let's extrude down a little bit. Like this, and then E to extrude again, and Alt plus M merge at center. We need to move this even more. Like that. Cool. Maybe a little bit bigger. Alright, I wanna create the food for this. So let's insert here also, and then let's extrude down and maybe scale a little bit, maybe even more, and let's disable the proportional editing because I think we don't need that. And extrude again, and then scale, and then extrude, and then extrude and scale. And this is the shape I wanted to have. Expect I think this would be thinner. Yeah. Alright, now I can start beveling things. So Alt plus Shift plus right mouse button, I select these, and Control plus B, I bevel them to smooth the shape. Like that, and let's do here also some beveling job. I think bevel is the best thing in Blender. Right, let's bevel also here a little bit. And then these. So here bevel. And then these. Actually maybe only this. And Control plus B. And here a little bit bigger bevels. Like that. And then smooth shading. And I will move everything a little bit up. This might actually be a little bit too long. I don't know why, but I think it should be a little bit shorter. So I select those, and then I just move them a little bit up. And I will also make it a little bit thinner. So I select this. I think I need to select here one hand Control plus. Let's select this wall detailed here, and then let's start deselecting here. Alt plus C plus right mouse button again is the shortcut. And S to scale and C plus Z. So now with this we can make it a little bit, I don't know, better. And let's select this one and let's bevel also this. Alright, I think this is very good shape now. So let's create a material for that. And here in the materials, let's click new and let's call this glass. And guess what? We are going to use the principled material again. So let's find it. Well, let's find it and then put here the surface and let's see how it looks like. Okay, it doesn't look glass at all. And the reason is that we need this transmission. And it's still not looking a glass because we have this roughness here. So let's also reduce the roughness. And please Blender don't grass. Okay, Blender crashed. Okay, so let's try again. So let's reduce the roughness. And let's see how it looks like. Okay, it looks like a glass, just like expected. Let's add here volume absorption and let's connect it to the volume slot and let's add it some cool color, maybe a little bit more thickness to that. And also I wanna add here subdivision surface. Let me see. Okay. Not bad. And I will also create some viewport color to that. Okay. And now I wanna create some table to this. So let's center the cursor back to the original point by pressing C plus C. And let's add here a plane. And let's start scaling it. Actually in edit mode it's better. So we don't need to apply the scale. And it seems like that I need to move it a little bit down. Like that. Now if we render, we have some sort of table here. And I think at this point we should find the place where we wanna render it. And I think I think I have very good place at the moment already. So this light source is kind of having this area illuminated with the light, but there is also a shadow visible in this scene. So that's the goal. Maybe I rotate this even more. Like that. So the shadow is more visible. Yeah, not bad idea. And also, we need some texture for this. I have been waiting so long to add some texture here. But yeah, let's first select this cake one material. And let's add here image texture. And let's connect it to the... Let's first find the texture. And I already created some texture. And I will make an upload link for it. So you can download it. It's in the description. The textures are in the description. So I have here this one. And let's add here mix RGB. And let's drag and drop this here actually in the boat. And let's connect this here and this to the color. And here let's use maybe overlay. And then here Ctrl plus T and object. So now if we press numpad slash we can see a little bit better what's going on. Okay, the texture is kind of there but it's not perfect and you see this distortion in the sides. So we need to select here box and then a little bit blend and it's a lot better like that. And let's see what happens if we have those in that way. Or color. Let's try that way. Alright, I think I'm gonna stay with overlay. So I just reduce a little bit of this intensity of this texture. Something like that I think is very good. And I also wanna use the same texture here in the displacement, so I just connect it there. So now there is kind of some sort of additional details there. And let's copy all of these. Control push C, and then let's go to cake 2 and let's paste it there, and let's connect. Let's drag and drop this. Wait. This here and this here. And then this to the displacement. And maybe I reduce the intensity a little bit so we have a little bit contrast between those two. Maybe I make this a little bit lighter. Okay, not bad idea, I think. Okay, I think that might actually work. Just like that. Let's add also some noise here so the quality of the cake is not so even in everywhere, because it's a cake and there should be some kind of darker spots around. So let's add here noise texture, let's save also every time, and let's mix it with this overlay node, and then let's here use maybe multiply, and I will, instead of color, I will use this factory, and now with this we can control how the thing looks like. I actually think that I will add here also the color ramp node. So let's find the color ramp and let's make the texture a little bit more contrasty. And maybe those are a little bit too small, those spots there. So I will just change this until I'm happy with it, with the size of those things. Something like that, and then I just reduce the amount until I think it's not too obvious what we did there. And let's copy all of these three again. You can, by the way, make a group of those, but I'm just working like that. And then let's use here the same trick. And let's maybe change a little bit here these settings. Okay, that's good. Then let's press number slash again to go back from that mode. Yes, good. And the next thing I'm gonna do is that I will go to textures.com, and from here I will search Petal, and I will download maybe this one. Yeah, I'm gonna download this one, and this is going to be some sort of romantic thing. It's kind of someone's wedding or somewhere there might be this kind of things on the table. So I download this one, and I can't provide you the upload link, sorry. So you must download it here. So textures.com, and then you find here Petal, and then you can download it and you can do the steps I'm doing here. So let's go here back, and then I'm gonna use one add-on which is going to be called images as plain. So activate this one and save user settings, and with this we can print the petal here. So let's add here mesh images as plain, and then we need to find the texture. So for me, I saved it here, and then I have it there. So now if we render, we have here this new object, but we need to edit a little bit. The add-on created this setting automatically, and if you didn't have this, then you must create it by yourself, or you need to do it like this, images as planes, and then from these, actually where are they, F6, okay, I don't know, but yeah, you should have something like this here. And let's delete this diffuse and let's add here the principled. We need it in everything. And the color to the base color. And now if you render, the material is a little bit different, but not too much. I press numpad slash again, so I don't need to render every time everything else. And now I will just change the settings. I will add here a little bit subsurface. And I connect this also to the subsurface color like that, and this is a problem, so let's reduce the amount of specular. And let's add more roundness. There should not be that kind of. So sign parts. Maybe we edit this object a little bit. Let's add here more segments. Control plus R. Why am I not having those? Oh, and then Control plus R again. And then let's here use the enable proportional editing and then random. And then we just move a little bit here. So we have random details in this object. And then smooth setting. Let's see again. Okay, that might be a little better, I guess. I will also select this and the smooth fall off, and I just wanna have a little bit. A bit more, I don't know, realism to the shape of this. Okay, that I think is very good now. And then let's add here curves. Let's connect it here and let's add more light to the subsurface scattering. And let's see. Yeah, it's working perfectly. So that's the pedal model. Now we just need to add lots of these around. And how I do that, I select the pedal object and I move it here. And shift plus C, and here physics add active, and then I select this one and I add active here, and this one, and this is also going to be active, and then this one. Okay, now I have the setup ready. So now if we play from the not like that. This should be passive, and this should be passive, and this should be passive also. So now if we play, the pedal is kind of dropping there nicely. Okay, then here let's select 3D cursor. When it's there centered with C+C, we can go in top view and duplicate this and rotate. Actually Alt+D and then rotate. Let's see. Yeah, very good. Let's duplicate again and, you know, keep adding this. Maybe we can also rotate a little bit. Let's use now individual origins. So. So it's kind of more random. Okay, let's select all of these again. I actually think that we should move them to the other layer. So let's press M when all of them are selected and move them to this layer. And why I do this is that I can now very easily isolate all of these. So here I just can select them all by pressing A. So Alt+D, rotating Z, 3D cursor, rotating Z axis. Move a little bit up maybe. And let's see. And some of them are going to drop down, which is completely okay also. And now I just need to keep duplicating these and moving around. Let's go here and select everything and select here individual origins and then S to scale them a little bit smaller. Nice. And the 3D cursor here again, and Alt+D duplicate and rotate in Z axis. Maybe move a little bit down. And Alt+D rotate in Z axis. This is kind of very repeating job. Alt+D rotate in Z axis. And let's see. Okay, let's see how this scene looks like now. And if you have those pedals there. I think those are very nice and I wanna have more of those. So I select all of them and Alt+D and then manipulate center points only. So and then median point and then I can just scale them like this. So you know. We have them everywhere. And then let's play the animation. And that's alright. How it looks like now. Alright, I think I'm very happy about this. We can edit this distribution of these pedals later, but I think we have no very good amount of these and maybe not more need to be added, at least not now. Okay, let's add some color also for those and to the viewport, something like this. I think looks very cute or good or whatever. And then we can play a little bit with other things with lighting basically. So I wanna create some sort of romantic light here. So how I do that, that's just one way, but I create here UV spheres and then I scale this to something like this. I think this is very good size and I add it here and then here tools smooth setting. Okay, so that's the first light source and let's select it and let's create new material and let's call it light. And of course we are not going to use the diffuse here either. But we are going to add here emission shader and let's connect it to the surface like this and then the other one is the principled and let's mix those two together. So now let's isolate it for a while and let's see. Okay, looking something, but let's reduce the roughness from that principle, because I think this is some sort of plastic thing, and the inside of that thing there is some sort of lead and battery and things like that. And let's make the color something like that, I think is very good. And let's add more strength to that also. I think this is very cool like that. And then we wanna add here this kind of node, layer weight. So let's use this facing here. So now in the center of this, if we control plus shift plus left click two times, you see, in the center we have here this emission, and then in the sides we have this principled PSDF. Maybe we add for this principled also a little bit yellowish color, so it's kind of more obvious. And let's try with this subsurface scattering. This is actually very nice idea, because I have no idea what would happen if we have mixed like that. But there is actually almost no effect at all. Yeah, it was just nice test. But yeah, I don't need that. I think it's not needed feature in this render. Okay, now we can with this control a little bit about the fade. And I think something like that might be 0.6 is very good, I think. So let's go out from the rendered mode, and this material is now ready. We can duplicate these now around, so we have this kind of glowing bubbles around wherever we think those are nice. So something like that. And I'm not going to overlap them with the petals, so I just find the spots where there is no petal, and then I have this kind of sphere there. Alright, let's go to camera view and let's see how this thing looks like now. Looks very neat, I think. Let's select this table, whatever, and let's create a material also for this. So let's score this table, and I'm not going to use wood texture here. Let's delete the diffuse and let's add principled, and let's add it here, and then surface, and let's isolate it for a while. I wanna make it a little bit darker and maybe a little bit blue tint. Or maybe not. Let's see how it looks like later. And something like that I think is very good. So let's see how it looks like. Okay, maybe that blue tint was not a good idea. And maybe a little bit lighter. Okay, not bad. And then the last thing, at least almost last thing, is to add some sort of backdrop here. And for that I go to pixabay.com. Here. Pixabay.com. And this is free public domain webpage. So I will find here restaurant. And I select this one. And then I will find some cool background for this image. You can select whatever. For example, this would look very good. And I'm trying to find image where there is something in the background but not too close. For example, this is, I think, bad because those are a little bit too close. So I will just keep scrolling. Okay, with the search word bar I found this image. So this is the image I'm gonna download, and this is going to be alright. So let's select here. I think this size is very good, and actually I already downloaded it. So I'm just going to Blender, and then I'm going to use that images as planes thing again. And then I go to the folder where I had the image here, and I just add it here, and then disable this one and scale it. like this and rotate in z-axis. And now if we render, we have the background there. Neat, and I need to move it a little bit, of course. And then scale. That seems to be alright, and I will delete the diffuse. And now you think, okay, he's going to add the principle, but no, I'm going to add emission. And I connect this here and this color to the color of emission. And why I add emission is the reason is that the background is, of course, should emit light to the scene also. And now I need to rotate this. Actually, let's go here in material mode so we can see the background here a little bit better. Okay. So I need to rotate the camera so the scene is kind of matching a little bit better with the background. Okay, I am not trying to be too specific with this. I wanna have actually a little bit up from the view, but you know. And then I rotate this in z-axis, so I will match this with the tables. And then scale y, and I scale x, and I press that x 2 times, so I can scale them in this direction like that. Rotate in z-axis a little bit. Okay, that I think is very good. And then I actually wanna extrude it a little bit, because I wanna have here bevel in this edge, which is going to be this scene. So let's see what happens if we have little bevel here. Okay, now we have even the chair there. Okay, that's good. Now let's select this camera and let's go to camera settings. And let's click this limits. And then let's change this distance value so we have the focal point of the image here in the cake. Somewhere like this, and then let's change the aperture value of this camera. So now if we render again, we should have blurriness there, just like we have, just like expected. And maybe we have a little bit too much of that, so let's put here something like 0.2 maybe. Okay, maybe that will do. Then I'm going to use an environment texture here, HDRI, and for that I will find from hdriheaven.com this website, and you should just find something that is good for me, good for you. Find maybe indoor and then something here. I think I'm going to use this one or this one. Of this one, but I already have something here, so I just here use notes and then click this button and select environment texture and then open and then go to the folder where I have all of those, and here I select interior and then I select this image which I downloaded. So now we should have realistic lighting for this scene. Let's select the camera, Control plus B, like this, so we don't need to render everything. Alright, some last minute edits before rendering. I select this part here, and I think I should remove a little bit the amount of bump mapping. Something like this might be a little better. And I really wanna have a little bit more smooth shading there, so the chocolate or whatever, toffee or whatever, I think it looks a little bit more tasty when it's like that. Or what do you think? I also changed a little bit the camera angle. And then I wanna edit a little bit this light source, so let's select it here and then I will make it a little bit smaller. That, and then I rotate it a little bit. This is just fill light, so I also make a little bit less strength. But as you can see, there is a reason why this lamp exists. If I add here zero, it's a little bit too dim. Because, so I really wanna have this light source here. And actually rotate it like this, so now it's even in the background of this thing. Okay, and then I duplicate this light source and I add it like this, so it's completely in the background. And this is going to be an area lamp, so let's select area and then rectangle, and then let's make it quite big like that. So with this I can add a little bit contrast here in the edge areas of this thing. So we need more strength also to this. Okay, I will make it a little bit wider. Even wider. And let's add even more strength. Specular, and let's check this background. And it's so red, the background, that I think I should a little bit remove the red color from it. I mean more blue. So let's go to red channel in this curves, and then maybe let's add a little bit more blue. Because the background is not something that we are going to look in this image. We wanna look the cake. So we can make the background even darker. Remove that one. Okay. Let's try with the blue channel again. Okay, that I think is better. And now let's select this one and let's add a little bit more yellow there. So we have cool contrast there. And in top view I make it away. And let's add more strength, maybe quite a crazy amount, and let's see how it works now. Maybe I add more whiteness. Okay, I will duplicate this, and I add here one additional light source. Because I really wanna have some highlights here, but it's not working with that one, so I will create another copy of it. Something like this, and let's see how it works now. Okay, it works, but it's a little bit too strong. Okay, not bad. Let's duplicate it and let's rotate in Z-axis to create similar effect here also. So now we have lots of cool contrast between the background and the cake, which is what we of course wanted also. And I will also add a little bit more back the aperture size. Like this. And by the way, I added also a focus object here, which is this empty here. So now this is the object I selected with the camera. And now the focus is always here, as you can see. And the last thing I did here is that I added here one segment in here and here and here, and then I also activated here the experimental feature, and then I have this adaptive subsurf there, and then all the materials where I wanna have the micro displacement, I selected this boat from the settings to the displacement, so that allowed me to have this result. And everything else is from Photoshop. that was the tutorial, and I hope you enjoyed it and don't eat too much cake. Okay, see you in the next video.